So the first myth that I will talk about, myth number one, is the myth of adequate air ventilation. And the myth is that PTAC units are widely believed to provide the code required ventilation air based on manufacturer's literature or implied literature. The reality is PTAC units are unlikely to provide code required ventilation. The belief in this myth is the reason that the majority of PTAC equipped hotels do not have an alternative way to properly ventilate individual guest rooms. Quite often a card or makeup air system is used in order to provide the ventilation air to the guest rooms, and that has to rely on an undercut under the guest room door. This is often not allowed. It doesn't comply with many building codes. The reason is that the undercut has to be at least 1.5 inches high in order to allow adequate amount of ventilation air to get into the guest room. And this would interfere with guest privacy concerns, among other issues. Most building codes will reference the ANSI ASHRAE standard 62.1 for required ventilation rates. And that usually requires a minimum of 30 cubic feet per minute of continuous ventilation air. So with the absence of a dedicated outside air ventilation system, the PTAC unit must be relied on to provide this proper introduction of fresh air. However, for a PTAC unit to perform this function, several things must happen. The PTAC unit indoor supply fan must be introduced the required quantity of outside air. The PTAC vent door must be open, and the PTAC indoor fan must run continuously, which is often a problem because occupants will control the PTAC units and they'll either turn off the fan or actually reduce the fan speed. And the last thing that's necessary is that the outdoor air quantity must be measurable and verifiable. And that's often very difficult to do with typical test and balance methods. The picture here shows the typical outdoor vent in the bulkhead separating the indoor and outdoor sections of the PTAC chassis. Some manufacturers say that this 70 CFM is possible through the operable door. However, we don't believe that this can be achieved. This might be achievable in factory bench tests, but our experience that these rates are not achieved in actual field conditions. And how we test this in the field is using micromanometers. And it's an indirect way to measure ventilation effectiveness of PTACs. And in our estimation, you need to have at least +5 pascals positive pressure in a hot, humid climate in order to prevent mold and moisture problems. In this particular case, where we've got measuring the PTAC is on, the damper is open, the corridor HVAC system is in normal operation, and the toilet exhaust is on, and we're measuring the demising wall between units, we found that we were getting a -9 pascals of pressure in this room compared to outdoors. So the reason that the PTAC is not likely to provide the code required ventilation is primarily one of the big things is the guest controls the PTAC fan. You just have no way of limiting that unless you prevent the occupant from doing any control, which is often difficult to do. As I've mentioned before, they can shut the PTAC off and they can also change the fan speed. The other issue is that the pressure drop through the vent door air filter is higher through the pressure drop through the evaporator coil and filter. Majority of PTAC manufacturers describe how the vent door may be open or closed, but provide little or no guidance to the moisture impact of an open vent door. The manufacturer's vent door guidance in their literature is without clear direction, even in warm, humid climates, and usually relates to the increased energy impacts of an open vent. In short, there is an absence of cautionary notes on the increased risk of moisture problems that can result from open vent doors. This figure shows the vent door open and the natural path or infiltration outdoor air is passed through the outdoor coil, that's the red arrows, and then through a washable filter at the vent. The ventilation air in this PTAC unit does not pass through the cooling coil before being mixed with the return air. Return air is in yellow, it goes through the evaporator coil, is cooled, which is the blue arrow, and then is mixed with the outside air, the red arrow, and discharged in the room, which is the green arrow. The result of this situation, increased room humidity because the outdoor air has not been properly dehumidified as it passes through the PTAC unit and actually is not even touched by the cooling coil. in a hot, humid climate, wouldn't keeping that door closed then prevent the outside air from coming in, and you wouldn't have that humidity problem? And yes, that'd be one way of solving that. The problem, as we're talking about in this presentation, though, is that we're expecting this PTAC, in absence of any other makeup air system into the room from another source, we're expecting this PTAC unit to not only provide code required ventilation, but also positively pressurize the room. And with the door closed, that's not going to happen, because you're not going to be bringing in outside air to do that ventilation and pressurization. However, even with the door open, as we've stated, you're not going to get the ventilation and pressurization that is really required to adequately keep a room from having problems with mold.